Hello, this is Craig Mertens. I am the co-founder and general manager of Digital Art Solutions. Hey, thanks for coming hanging out with us today. Today we're going to be introducing the newest graphics collection in our company. And the collection is called Mask Builder. We're going to talk a little bit about what it is and why we decided to do this and kind of the concept behind it. I'll be full disclosure here. This is one of the harder products that we've ever produced because it's new territory. When you're looking at creating a graphics product that's specific to, quite honestly, a product that wasn't even on our radar 6 months ago, it's all kind of new territory. So it actually required quite a bit of research to figure out the design side and the production side to make it easy for people to use. And I think we really nailed it. It was quite the project, but it turned out great. You guys will get a chance to see it here today. I want to talk a little bit first. I want to talk about the business opportunity for masks. It's really an interesting kind of a phenomenon. When COVID hit and started really impacting our lives back in March, I remember I couldn't even get a mask. You couldn't order them. They weren't on Amazon. You couldn't even get one. And I had a client that was nice enough that was making masks with his embroidery equipment that sent my wife and I a little care package of masks. And those were the masks that we had for probably, pretty much through April before masks started coming online. Then came this massive influx. All these manufacturers, including big retail brands, kind of, they ended up pivoting to masks, right? And when I talked to clients that, and I talked to two customers today, same story. They're both Inksoft owners. They both are involved in multitude of production processes, including sublimation. And you know what they did? They pivoted to masks, and they pivoted to like kind of school fundraising type programs and community fundraising programs, primarily with their online selling. And as a result of that, their businesses have been able to weather the storm. And we've heard that same exact story over and over again. And one of the things that was neat about the unfortunate reality of us being involved in masks, because it just became this thing that none of us would have really anticipated. But for our clients that were making masks and decorating masks, they were in most states, they would have been declared essential businesses, and so they were able to stay open. And so they were able to have employees come into their place of work and do production, and they pivoted to masks. So masks have become a big part of our lives, regardless of how you feel about them personally. They're not going anywhere away anytime soon. Hopefully there'll be a day when we can say, hey, forget masks, but for right now, it's a big deal. And so what's happened is the decorated aspect of masks have kind of evolved. And if you kind of take a look, we'll talk a little bit about the specifics of Mask Builder. But the early masks were primarily basic cotton masks, and people would put usually a one or two color screen printed logo on them. And that was kind of how the early masks were produced. And what you started to see in the marketplace, you started to see these masks that were sublimated. And they were produced for two primary processes. One was a finished mask that would have ribbing around the edge, and that you would create a heat transfer with your sublimation system, and you'd print it, and it would create a complete imprint over the entire mask. And so that was kind of the first style. And then the second style of mask was what we call these cut and sew masks, where they print blocks of fabric and then they sew the mask together. And there's all kinds of different ways to do that. But what was kind of driving that whole, thing was this. If you go over here and go to, here's my favorite team. So hopefully nobody's going to be too excited about this, but Green Bay Packers, and I type in masks. If you kind of see what's going on the side of professional sports, look at all these different combinations. And some of these are really creative. And you look at this one right here, they're selling this as a kind of a three pack, and you buy a three pack and you get three different masks with your logos of your sports team, and you can represent out in the community. You have a little bit of team pride. And so the manufacturers of apparel and headwear and they kind of pivoted to making masks. And some of the graphics and some of the things that you see are really, really creative. And it's pretty neat what kind of evolved into the industry. And so what happened in the school team and sports market, people were starting to see folks that were in public and wearing these masks were going, hey, that would be really cool if I could have a cool mask like that. And but I'm just a high school or a middle school or an elementary school, and then our customers would kind of raise their hands and go, hey, we can do stuff like that. We can do stuff like that's that's even cooler. And so they started producing masks with their sublimation systems that were kind of on that same level as the, you know, what you're seeing in the professional sports licensing and collegiate licensing as well. And so it created this kind of secondary market of these kind of real high impact graphics and masks. And you know, from a perspective as of a designer, wow, you know, as terrible as the concept of having to wear a mask is, as good as it is as something to decorate. It's like literally kind of the perfect thing to decorate. It's a simple shape of it. It can really hold a nice graphic. It's centered up. It's easy to print on. So it's a kind of an ideal medium to create a graphic. And so what we did with Mask Builder is we kind of took a look at the professional sports and collegiate licensing and kind of the styles of graphics that were being produced there. And we said, let's produce a kit that is going to give our clients the ability to compete at that top level with graphics, because let's face it, the mask thing is competitive now. And so if you, oh, there's my coworker. So if you can produce a mask that has, you know, a more interesting or stimulating graphic, you don't necessarily get price shopped as well as much, and you can sell at a higher price. And one of the things about these sublimated masks that you'll see, they're being sold at a premium. And bear in mind that Mask Builder isn't just the sublimation market. So if you kind of take a look at what we did, is we built templates, and the templates are, they kind of fall into three different groups. We did a base template that has a cool little background pattern that you can edit, where it would just have a mascot. You could replace the school logo there or your own school's mascot. Then we did a version that it was a little bit more complex that had maybe a logo incorporated into it. So there you got the little logo. And then we did a version that's just the logo. And the just the logo version is the version of the file that you would utilize for doing, say you had a Okidata white toner printer or a DTG printer, or a thing that's very popular with masks is getting heat transfers manufactured and then on a master sheet and then cut them up into pieces and then doing the pressing that way. That's a real common way of doing it. I'd say direct screen printing is much less so. I don't see a lot of direct screen printing on masks, although there are people that do it, but a lot of our screen printer clients, they're actually getting transfers made instead of doing direct screen printing. It works a little bit better. So this style of mask would be, would this style of graphic would work really well in the context of a, you know, a transfer type process or direct to garment print. But these will work great over here in sublimation. And the right now sublimation is just blown up. It's actually hard to get printers right now because, and that's all because of mask production, because people are doing these school masks. And I talked to one of our vendors yesterday, and they just processed an order for 30,000 masks, sublimated masks for a school district. 30,000 pieces. Can you imagine? And the mask cost, I asked him what the cost on those. He says they were going out at $5.75 a piece. So must be nice to get a $170,000 order, right? Pretty cool. And the cost, the customer is making 40% on that. So wow, make your whole year. So I don't know, somebody can do the math on that, but last time I checked, that's probably going to be about 70,000 bucks, somewhere around there. Wow, pretty exciting. So when we produce this collection, let me kind of walk you through it. Let me show you what the kind of what the thinking was. Is this is what our thinking was. We wanted to take that same concept that we utilized in our graphics builder collections, where the graphics were modular, and so that you could mix and match, change colors, interchange design elements, mascots, logos between the different masks, and literally create unlimited combinations. And so the three masks that we used as kind of the representative examples, we used the standard cut and sew mask that you're seeing from manufacturers, people like SoCal or people like Founders Sportswear. They're doing this cut and sew sublimated mask where they print the fabric and sew it together. Some of those masks you can print edge to edge, so you can actually print up onto the finished seam here too. But we created that style of mask. This is the standard sublimated mask that you see in the industry. These masks are, you know, readily available from the different sublimation supply houses. We just did a class on Friday where David Gross from Condi Systems used his mask blank, and we live printed sublimated masks on our webcasts. And so this particular shell is modeled after the sublimated mask. This particular shell down here, This is a standard shape that you see in the cotton masks. And this shape here is really irrelevant to the production, but we wanted to create some of these basic templates so that you could kind of see what the designs were going to look like in the shape of a mask. And also you can use this as a sales tool. It's pretty cool because the way we set these files up, you can use any mask template. So if you have a mask template from another supplier, you can certainly use that as well. And so it's very flexible. Also being able to do gaiters. And gaiters is a whole nother world. And so we made this product flexible enough that you could do gaiters with it. So let me kind of take you through some of the concepts. One of the things that we did in the storyboard when we mapped this all out, we wanted to do all the popular school colors. So that's the University of North Carolina's colors, if you weren't aware of that. So we took the most popular school color combinations, and every single mask layout is a different school color combination. And, you know, again, this whole thing is designed to be interchangeable, but it is kind of neat how the colors kind of pop in here. This is this background element here. This is the whole element. And so if you want to incorporate that into a t-shirt in Adobe Illustrator, this is masked out. In CorelDRAW, these are what's using what's called a power clip, and we'll show you how that works. So I'll just kind of take you through a little spin here. We've included the names of the fonts that we've used here. We used our modern font set. So our modern font set is all of our kind of Marvel superhero comic book style fonts. So like our Iron Man font, our American Captain font, and Avengers style font. We used a lot of those kind of modern fonts. So we wanted to give it kind of a modern feel and look. And so utilizing all these really cool graphical elements. And then we used our newest set of mascots in here. And bear in mind, these mascots are really going to be utilized as a placeholder. And this is the way I kind of frame that. If you have a school and their mascot's not that great, it's not cool, you might just use this mascot because these are cool, right? And you're going to just maybe drop the name of the school in here. But a lot of times the schools are going to want to use their own mascot, and there's nothing to prevent you from doing that. You can certainly use the official mascot and to swap it in. And these are all templates, so all the text is live. You can edit that in Corel or Adobe Illustrator. Another thing that we did here is trying to really create a wide variety of backgrounds so that every background kind of stood on its own and had a kind of a different look. And so the thing that we would advocate with you guys when you're working with your customers is to pick three or four different styles and mock up three or four different styles. And a really smart way to do this is if you're selling them, take the same exact approach that you saw in the Green Bay Packers logo. Sell them in a three-pack. Sell them three-pack with three different layouts so they could utilize you know, kind of a different layout based on their theme. Like do a really simple one with just a logo, solid color, kind of your class it up type one, and then maybe one that's just kind of over the top, and then kind of a you know, kind of a media. Like you could just literally use all three of these, and you could tell the customer, you in your three pack, you could get all three of these. And going rate on these masks on Sublimated is between $10 and $15. So you could very easily do, and your cost on the mask is going to be, you know, between $2 and $4. So you could very easily do a three pack of 30 masks, and you have a cost less than, you know, a three pack for $30, and you have a cost of less than $10. That's $20 pop. So that's pretty good money. So we really tried to kind of mix it up in terms of the styles and the backgrounds and things and the elements, and they're all interchangeable. So you can interchange them between all the different graphics. So like if you wanted to take this cougar out, but you wanted to have that kind of that, you know, claw print, you put a bear in there, right? Or a wolf. Or talon marks, you could put an eagle in there. They're all kind of very simple, clean graphics, but the backgrounds, I think, are what really make them pop. And so we did a little camo action there with the gator. That's kind of fun. That's a really nice mascot there. And there's gradients and blends, which make it a little bit more visually interesting and stimulating. There you go. So it's was kind of a labor of love. Got a little bit of diamond plate there with the Knights design. We really challenged the art department to do something more interesting, more, you know, to outdo what we're seeing in the professional sports licensing. And if you see the stock graphics that people are doing from some of these mask builder type websites, like Founders, the graphics aren't that interesting to me. I mean, these are interesting graphics, and these are going to be at that level that you're going to see with the professional sports licensing and the collegiate licensing. And I feel like we really kind of nailed it there. So there you got the little feathers going on with your owl. Like that one a lot. That's a great mascot. So nice simple little razor back there. And there we use a little pattern background in there to give it kind of a weathered effect, a little bit of patina in there. So it looks like it's been weathered. Nice, bright, fun colors. You know, tiger mascots are always kind of fun to work with. So, and there you got the Viking. We even got the little Celtic Viking action going on behind the scenes there. So, and we use the kind of the reptile scales for the snake one. And that's the one that was featured on the website. Just simple, clean, basic graphic. And here's all the different mascots. There's 24 mascots. And then there's 24 different fonts that we used. And the font sets that we used is we did use, you know, our kind of our comic book style fonts in here and then some of our home decor fonts. But we tried to keep the fonts pretty basic. So they're not the dominant part of the graphic. The dominant part of the graphic will be the graphical element like the mascot, as well as the actual background element. So let me show you kind of how this whole thing is designed to work, and then we'll kind of play around with it, and we'll show you how to use this. So first things first, the product works in either CorelDRAW or Adobe Illustrator. Doesn't matter. If you have Adobe Illustrator, you can open up the templates and edit them manually. If you have CorelDRAW version X8 or higher, you can do the same thing, but if you're utilizing our Smart Designer add-on software for CorelDRAW, that's going to be very interactive. We're going to kind of streamline the design process, and we're going to do this in a couple different ways. Okay, and I'll explain it. When you purchase this product, and you would get a zip file, and that zip file would have all of the templates, all the fonts, all the clip art. It's a package, and you could just simply open these files up into your graphics program. In CorelDRAW, you'd use the import function because it would import a copy. In Adobe Illustrator, you'd use the open function and you would save a copy. So you'd go save as, so you wouldn't edit over the top of the original file. That's actually kind of important. So if you're using our Smart Designer add-on software for CorelDRAW, it's a little different because what we're going to do is we're going to activate the product in your content feed. So here's the Smart Designer Docker, okay, right here. So if you're a Smart Designer, owner, if you're a member of our Graphics Plus membership program, you're going to have Smart Designer, and Graphics Plus members have what's called the Content Manager. And so if I go over here and click on Subscriptions and Updates and click on Access Purchase Content, the Content Manager is going to open. And so if you buy this product, well, the first thing we're going to do, if you're a Graphics Plus member, we are going to activate that product in your content feed, and you're going to get a little message that says new content available. And then when you click on the little new content available message, it's gonna open up the content manager. And we'll kind of show you what the content manager looks like here in a second. So first things first, you notice I went to purchase downloads and there's Mask Builder. And so it'll just show up in your feed and all you gotta do to install it is just click on it, click on download and it'll install, pretty slick. Over here, these are all your Graphics Plus issues, the most current ones. So the current version and one version back, and then the special version that we did. So these are the most current Graphics Plus, and here's all your backup files. So there's all your backup files. So if you had to reinstall this on another computer, you could just move these folders to another computer, click on it, hit install, and you're done. And super duper easy. So in the context of Mask Builder, I would just check the box, click on download, it'll install, and then it's gonna show up in your graphics browser. So the graphics browser you would access by clicking on templates right here. And then graphics browser pops up. And a couple things. Number one, with the graphics browser, if you go to all folders right here, all folders, this is where you can access all the artwork on your computer. And this is just artwork that's on my desktop. We install what's called a preview extension for common file formats when we install Smart Designer. So that allows you to have file previews for things like AI files, PNG files, JPEGs already preview, but PDFs, EPS, AIs, PNGs, those are kind of the big ones. And so you can actually view all these graphics formats and you can view them in both the graphics browser and you can also view them on your desktop and in your folders. And that's because of us. We're installing that preview extension. So I just wanted to show you this because this is how you access your artwork. That's your artwork, not necessarily your DAS artwork. If you're going to access your DAS artwork, you're going to click on clip art right here. And I noticed I did a little keyword search for cougars. So all my cougars came up. So there's all my cougars. So if I want to put a different mascot in there, I could do that. But the graphics builder, or excuse me, mask builder was installed. And under clip art, if we go to mask builder, it's just going to show up right here. There's all the mascots. And you could just double click on a mascot to import it. Or if you wanted, you could just, you know, drag and drop it, or drag and drop a couple of them in there, and you're ready to go. And you notice that the graphics browser doesn't close, it just minimizes when you do that. If you go to templates, this is where we're going to take the base template right here. And the base template, again, it's going to be installed, and there's going to be two things to choose from: mockups right here. So there's your mockups and templates. So let's say you were going to use this and you were going to do a different sublimatable product or printable product, something that wasn't a mask. Maybe it was going to be a full wrap on a mug. Maybe it was going to be a clipboard. Maybe it was going to be a license plate frame. Something that is completely independent from a mask, just use the backgrounds here. They're really cool. Let me show you how we have them all set up. So I'm just going to import one of these and we'll play around with one. I'll show you how we set these up. Let's do this kind of exciting one here. So we'll go ahead and just double click on it. So there's your background, came in at scale. And so it's actually the correct scale for the particular, you know, the general mask, but this is vector art. So you can make these bigger or smaller and change the orientation and all that kind of stuff. So on this design right here, the mascot is free floating. So the mascot is free floating. So we can, you know, just move it, and I'll put the mascot over here. And maybe we'll go over here to clip art. And maybe we go over here to these mascots, and just, you know, for future reference, maybe we want to maybe use a different mascot in here. So we'll pop that guy in here because we might use that guy later. Okay, so we've got the design. It's got wings. We probably aren't going to use the tiger, but we could. Okay, so this right here is a power clip. And so if you notice, as soon as I clicked on that, it says edit. And so if you click on edit, that means that you can expand all this part. And if you want, you can resize that and reposition it. Look at, you see what I'm doing? Resizing and repositioning. And when you're done, just hit finish. Boom, that's a feature of power clipping. I'm gonna undo that by clicking Control Z. Okay, so we went back to the original. And I don't know if you noticed, that's the complete object. So even though it's showing it being cropped, if we go edit, it's the whole deal. So you got the whole graphical element there. That is super duper cool, okay? Now the other thing you can do is you can extract it. So if you extracted it, you would right click on it. That's a Corel thing. You could also, if you clicked on it, you go over here and you have a little keyboard shortcut for extract. So two ways, click on it here, extract, or right click on it here and extract. And then you just pulled the elements out. So we just pull those elements out and you got the little background here. If you pull the elements out, if you say you just didn't want these little yellow things in here, or you wanted to change the color of those little yellow things, maybe make them orange, or you do this. This is kind of cool. Check it out. Just take the little tiger here and drag them down into your document palette. And then you could click on that and just whoop, make that the same color orange, why not? And well, it looks pretty good. And what you could do from here is kind of get this all set up. So I'm thinking maybe go with the blue and this background color. I think I'm gonna make that gray. So check it out, just take the dropper and select the color from right here and then drop that in there. This X, what this X is indicating is that's a power clip frame. And what that means is if I hover this set of graphical elements over it, watch what happens. As soon as I hover it over, watch what happens. It just sucks it right in there. That's a power clip frame. So if I wanted to move that around, what I could do is, I'm just gonna extract it again. We'll just do a Control Z here, get back to there. Cause what I really wanna do is change the shape of this. So maybe we'll make a different shape. Maybe this is gonna go on a gator, right? So make it bigger for the other shape. It's going to pull right in there. Or better yet, let's do this. You can add different elements too. Just say edit and maybe make it a little bit smaller like that. And we'll move that down. It's not quite even, so we'll move that down. Just using my arrow keys. Also, you can just grab your control key and move it, and it'll keep it on a plane, so to speak. Okay, so when you're done, just hit finish. So maybe you want to add some additional graphical elements. Why not? Let's get in here and let's go and grab a different element. So I'm just going to draw a rectangle real quick right here, and we'll make that the blue. And I'm going to move that up here, and then I'm going to put another rectangle right here. Just going to right click to copy it. We'll make that white, and then we'll do another one right here. Right click to copy it. We'll make that orange. Okay, and then I'm just going to group these together. Control G, group. Okay, power clip. You can just power clip that in here, man. Check it out. Just drag her and drop her. It's going to go right here. Well, let's make another copy because we're going to do two of these. So I'm going to move that and right click to copy it. And then let's just pop that bad boy right in there. See that little bomb sight? Check it out. Release it. Power clip. Bam. The sound effects are extra. So, and then we're going to do the same thing over here. Power clip it. Bam. There you go. So, got the cool little background, and we'll take our little tiger here, and we'll take the tiger and we'll just put the tiger right in there. And there we go. If we want to add some text, we could do that. And so let's go over here. We'll pick one of those cool fonts. So we'll do the galactic font. So that's kind of your Guardians of the Galaxy font there. And I just copied that by right clicking and moving it. So I should show you that again. Watch. Click it, drag it with your left mouse button, right click to copy it. And then you can just click on your little mouse here and just say tigers. And let's give both of these an outline. So watch. Select them, right click, give it an outline. We go to the outline tool over here, double click on it, make it a little bit thicker. Send it behind the object. That's what behind fill does. Scale it with the object. So if you scale it up or down, you've got that. And then we'll put that right like that. We'll put that right like that. You select them both and hit C, you'll center them. So we got our cool little background. And so, you know, if we're going to do a gator, I might just have a gator template here on my desktop. Let's see here. Yep, sure do. So I'm just going to copy this whole graphic, and then we're going to remember that power clip feature? We're going to power clip this whole thing into the gator. So watch, same deal. Boom, boom, boom. Power clip inside, there you go. And on this one, what you're gonna wanna do, you're gonna wanna go edit. You're gonna wanna move that down, and you're gonna wanna move that up. And when you're done, hit finish. So there's your super awesome gator template. Wow, so pretty amazing, huh? So, you know, all I did is I just kinda worked up a custom graphic using the background elements, and we recolored it. We added a kind of a couple other little dynamic little graphical elements. We swapped out the mascot. I just typed in some text, and you know, not bragging, but I don't see a lot of, you know, work being done at this level in terms of graphics, except from the big, you know, brands. You know, this is the kind of thing that you're seeing from the, you know, if you watch the sidelines of the professional sports over the weekend. This is the kind of work that you're seeing. And those are done by big, you know, kind of big branding and licensing companies that have sophisticated art departments. And guess what you have? You have the most sophisticated capability now for creating graphics in our industry. Isn't that nuts? And that's because we've created this incredible tool called Graphics Builder that allows you to do this kind of custom work. So we're going to leave that right there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to show you how you would use an actual mask mockup, which is going to be a little different. Okay. So again, we're going to go back to templates and we're going to go to the Mask Builder folder, but we're going to go to mockups and we'll go down here and we'll pull a different one out. Let's see. Kind of like that lion. Ooh, this one's cool too. These are all cool. So we'll do that wildcat one. Yeah, we'll do this one. So I'm going to choose this option right here. So I'm just going to double click the template. That's going to pop up and let's localize it. So in Smart Designer, it says templates, it says edit text, and it says Wilson. So we'll call this West View. And the text is going along the path in Wildcats, and we'll call this, I don't know, the Eagles. So it's the West View Eagles. Yeah, Wildcats kind of works with West View, doesn't it? So the West View Eagles, okay, and we want to swap that mascot out. So I'm just going to say change art, and the part that I want to swap out is the clip art, which is right here. And so again, we're going to click on select, open the graphics browser, boogie over to the clip art, and we want to do an eagle. And this is the eagle. We could use any eagle, but we'll just use this dude. Eagle's going to pop in there. Actually, you know what? I don't really want to do an eagle in there. You know what I want to do? I want to do a sports element. And so let's put in that graphic right there. We're going to draw that and we're going to swap that out with the graphic. So let's put a sports element. We don't have to do a mascot. So let's go over here and type in football's getting started again. So football, and we'll hit a little search button there. And this is going to go through all my DAS artwork. And I'm sure we'll find one that just fits perfect. I think we could put a helmet in there. We could put just like a football. We got a lot of football artwork. So it's going to take a little while to search through all that. All right. So let's see here. We do like a classic old helmet. That one looks good. Let's see here. I'm going to do something kind of colorful. That's like the classic helmet right there. So let's go ahead and just double click on that helmet. And the helmet's going to come in here. And then we'll take that helmet and we'll just position it right smack dab in the middle of this right there. And then we just got to get the colors all straightened out. Looks good. So we'll make it a little bit bigger. Nudge it over there and we'll get the colors squared away. So what we're going to do is we're going to go down to here where it says modify colors, and there's all the colors in your design. And then we can go and do a little bit of a swap there. Actually, to tell you the truth, the easiest way, this might actually be easier just to manually recolor versus doing a swap. So we could just go in and do a little manual recoloring on this. Now, the other thing that we could do on this template would be change the shape, or we can extract the actual part from the graphic right out of here. So this particular graphic is actually power clipped into the shape, and we can extract that and just work on the rectangle too. So we're not, you know, stuck with just working on the actual graphic. Now, one of the things that's super cool about all of these is when you're working with them, let's see here, go back to our gator. go. You can just make it bigger. So if you were doing the actual production side of this, a couple things. Number one, you could take this file right here and you could extract the contents and you could work off of the rectangle, just like we were doing before. Or you can keep it inside the rectangle. We use the modify colors function right here to kind of scan the design. And what we can do here is if we want to swap the colors into Pantones, we can do that. And then we can swap out the colors in the graphic. So the dominant color in this graphic is actually that gold. So if we go over here and go to swap, Smart Designer's color swap, we can make that color like reflex blue. So there's reflex blue. Then what we could do is we could make the background of the mask, instead of having that be black, we could have that be gray. So we'll go and swap that out. You can type in the color number too. So I'll just make it cool gray 6. And that was the color from the color of the strap and the color of the mask were the same color. So it swapped both those out. So let's undo that. Do it this way. Let's just go ahead and edit the power clip. And let's just click on that right there. And we can just make it gray. And then when we're done, just say, oops, we're gonna make the background gray, right? Oh, we got a power clip inside of a power clip. So that's the part we're going to make gray. We're going to finish editing that. Then we're going to finish editing this. And then we're going to do a little bit of manual coloring. So I'm going to grab my dropper. And then we're going to drop that color gray into that text. Oh, I see what's going on. It's a different black. We just do a swap. All right, so we're going to make that. I don't know. We could go with orange again. And let's see here. Just select it. And we'll make that orange. And then we'll make this orange. There's that. And let's see. Oh, it looks good. Pretty happy with that. So on the production side of things, what you would do on the production is if you're doing an actual sublimated product, what you're going to want to do is make this shield or that little crest there smaller. And here's why you want to do that, because you're going to take this particular part of the graphic. This has came in and it's in scale. You want to make that bigger. So when you actually do the transfer is overprinting the whole thing. So when they print these, this particular mask has a black banding around it. And so when you print it, this is what you're going to print. You're going to print a whole bunch of squares like this. And I'll show you kind of how they would lay this out. They would typically sublimate these in terms of multiples like that. And then you would trim them up with scissors and you'd have a different sublimation transfer for every mask. That's basically the way you would do it. Now, the other thing that you could do here is if you had a mask that was like some of the new masks, like the 2-ply masks, the 2-ply masks have, this whole thing is white, okay? So this whole deal right here is white, okay? So with the 2-ply mask, what people do is they use hot heat tape, which is a tape that can withstand the heat, and they actually tape off this part. And then when you do that, you can have it print all the way up until the edges. But you just have to make sure this is bigger than the graphic. So when you print like that, You just have to make sure you put heat tape over the ear loops so that it's not going to print onto the ear loops, but it'll actually print all the way up into here and here. And typically you're going to do that with the 2-ply masks. You don't see too many 3-ply masks where I, at least I haven't seen any 3-ply masks where you can print, you know, edge to edge. Most of the 3-ply masks have the banding around the perimeter of them. So you get quite a bit of flexibility. Now for the companies that are doing the, you know, the cut and sew mask, they're printing a big old square and they're printing blocks roughly to the shape of the mask part, and they're larger. So like in this case, the printing block for this, if they're doing a finished mask, is going to be basically this shape right here. Actually, it was a cheater way to do that. You just put a boundary around it. But for folks that are doing the printing the blocks, their block of fabric is going to be, this is their template's going to be something like this, and it'll be to scale. So if you send this to the manufacturer and they're doing this cut and sew application, if they're doing cut and sew, they're going to have a template like this that is the shape that they need to print for their printing blocks. So what they're going to do, they're going to have bulk fabric, they're going to have the transfers created from their sublimation printer, and they're going to heat press that onto the bulk fabric. And some of these bigger operations, they're using roll fed heat presses, and they're using, you know, printers that are, you know, 54 inches wide with a roll fed heat press. So they're doing mass production. And so once they have the printed fabric block, then the people in the sewing department sew this into a mask. It's already printed. That's a really cool way to do it. And the super professional looking masks that you see on you know, the sidelines of the college and NFL games right now, that's how they're doing them. They're doing them printing blocks and then sewing the mask together. And so there's all kinds of different companies that will do that production work for you. So that's a pretty typical example of doing a sublimated mask. So the main thing to kind of keep in mind is this, and we'll kind of recap that again, is when you're doing, if you're working off a template, and we'll just go to mock-ups here. If you're working off a template, the graphic itself is going to be larger than the print area. Okay, so this graphic is going to have to be larger if you're doing a full bleed. This one is set up for a fabric block, but if you were going to sublimate this and you were going to go edge to edge, it'd have to be bigger. So you'd have to have it set up bigger. And in this case, what you'd want to do is make the mascot a little bit smaller. So, and then again, heat tape over the ear loops. So I'll go to wireframe view so you can kind of see how we set that up. So you have maximum flexibility for production. And the cool part is if you send these into one of the manufacturers that's doing this sewing block thing where they're sewing the blocks of fabric into finished masks, they know how to do all this stuff. So you're actually better off, in my opinion, sending them the rectangle. Just send them the rectangle. They'll lay it out. All those companies are going to send you a proof of what it's going to look like, but you're just better off sending them the rectangle. So how did I get that? I just right clicked and extracted it. There you go. That's how you create it. So what are some of the other kind of fun things that you can do with these? Here's some fun things you can do. You can make t-shirt graphics out of them. And so if you were going to go into this and you were going to do a mask template, and we'll make a cool little t-shirt graphic out of one of these. Yeah, this is a good one right here. So I'm just going to drag and drop that in there. And this is going to be kind of like a coordinate, so to speak. And so we'll just kind of keep this over here for now. And I'm going to make a copy of it. I'm just going to drag it and make a copy of it. And then I'm going to extract all the parts and pieces from it. Extract. So I got all the components over here, and we don't need this anymore. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take the word Hornets, and we're going to make that big like that. And I am going to change the outline width on that. And we'll make this outline quite a bit smaller. That looks pretty good. Maybe a little bit bigger, 0.75. Okay, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this background right here and I'm gonna squeeze it a little bit. You'll see what I'm doing. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger and then I'm gonna power clip this into the text. Power clip inside. And I think if you reverse the colors out on that, it's gonna be a lot more readable. And the other thing too, it doesn't need an outline, but let's see here. We'll power clip that in there. Yeah, looks good. So we've got that. If you can have an outline on that, it should have a black outline. And we'll thicken that up a little bit. Now what you could do, okay, we'll see if we like this. Here's what you could do. We might hate it, I'm just gonna tell you, it could be horrible, but we're gonna try something. What we're gonna do is in Smart Designer, we're gonna go over here to Effects, and we're gonna do just an outline effect on it. And that outline effect is gonna, we're not gonna trim the outline effect through the substrate. I'll show you what I mean by that. We're just gonna stack the effect. Yeah, it looks way better. So you got black right here, you got a white layer. If you're supplementing, that's the shirt color that's gonna come through because it's white. And then all we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and take the little mascot that we had. We're gonna take the whole darn thing. We don't need this anymore. And I think center it, I think we want to center it up. And one thing I want to do with this, I'm going to ungroup it. I'm going to give it a white outline. So I'm just going to right click to give it a white outline. And it's just going to be a tiny little white outline. Maybe, you know, we'll go with that kind of 0.75 thing again. I'm going to set it to behind fill and scale with the image. So it, you're not going to see it until we superimpose this. So we're gonna superimpose that and go object, order, move it to the front. Boom. It's looking good, good, good. All right. And actually it's pretty much the way I want it. So that looks good, about right like there. And then I'm just gonna take the word Harrison. We could steal that from this guy if we wanted to. I don't think we need it. We don't. I think you just have the word Hornets for the t-shirt. That's all you need right there. Okay, let's mock this up. I think it's gonna look pretty cool. So let's see what it looks like. So this one right here, we're just gonna select that. We're gonna go to virtual samples. I think that kind of begs to be on a gray shirt. And it's basketball season, so hey, why not? So there's that. And then we'll add that over to our little virtual sample layout. So go to proposal sheets in Smart Designer. I'll pick a layout here. And we'll do like style 2. And we'll add it. So let's get rid of that. And then we'll just add that. And we'll say create proposal. There's that. We'll move the little copy right down here. Move that down here. And then let's slap that mask in there. And this is how you get the 2-for-1. So you get the t-shirt and the mask. and they're coordinated. And that's how you roll right there. So I think if I was doing this, if I was back in the field repping, which I did for 10 years, I think what I would certainly do with this is I would present these as coordinates, that we have a combination with the t-shirt and the mask combo. And people will be all over that, especially if you're doing a fundraising store and you're putting that into a fundraising store. I just think that looks so super duper cool. You know, and you end up with something that's, I think, more dynamic looking than just having a, you know, just a mask by itself. And then you can spin these off into other things too. So then you could have a gaiter, a mask, and a t-shirt. You could have a hoodie and a gaiter. You could have a mask and a baseball cap. You know, there's all kinds of different things when you can coordinate the graphics. But the one thing that I wanted to showcase was the flexibility of Graphics Builder. It is really flexible. You can be like super lazy and just basically go in and just take a template and do nothing other than just change the text. You could do that. If you wanted to be super lazy and you just wanted to come in here and take one of these templates and change the text and the colors, you could do that. You know, it's not going to take you very long to do that. But on the other hand, you can be really creative with this and go in and really, you know, have some fun and do something more visually stimulating. You know, go in and edit the backgrounds, change the colors up, add and delete dissolve elements, you know, use a different mascot, put a sports icon in there. You know, it's really up to you. There's no rules. And so what we wanted to do ultimately was create like the building blocks of creating great graphics for masks. What we inadvertently did was we created the building blocks of just creating great graphics for other things too, t-shirts and other sublimatable products. So it's really a very flexible product, and this would be cool to actually incorporate these into mugs too. I think mugs would be a good one to do there as well. So the overall scope of the product is it's a very simple product, but it's very powerful in terms of the way you can edit the graphics. And one of the things that I'm going to advocate, I think it's really important, is that you experiment. This is one of these products that I think if you play around a little bit and you kind of bone up on your power clipping and Corel and you experiment, I think you guys can get some graphics that are, you know, what we're doing here is pretty stellar, but I certainly think that you can get graphics that are an improvement on what we're doing. Because at the end of the day, you know what you have here? You have a whole bunch of design elements, and you can mix and match those design elements literally in limitless combinations. You know, if you extract the contents from that, and then you extract the contents from the rectangle, look at all these parts that you have here. Holy smokes. You got that part, this part, you got all these, you got the background in here. I mean, you can go nuts with that. So there you go. So, you know, I think you kind of have it both ways. Way number one is just utilizing the template as it is and swapping the mascot and the colors out and changing the text. And that's certainly, there's nothing wrong with doing that. And that's actually, I think, a really good way to use the product. But way number two is just going, you know, no offense, hog wild on the custom. There you go. That was a terrible joke. So there you go. So that's it. That's what Graphics Builder is all about. When you get the product, one of the things that I'm going to recommend doing is you should go right to samples. You should create a sample for two reasons. Number one, we're going to do a design contest, and you can enter your sample in our design contest. And number two is customers really need to see this, and getting a real product that's actually produced that is in the context of a physical sample. You know, if you printed up a couple dozen of these and just with a generic or a popular school in your area or just a generic made up school, and you pop those in the mail to a couple key buyers, I got to tell you, you're going to get some bites on that. And you don't have to necessarily, you know, do it that way. You could also email them a comp. So there's nothing to prevent you from taking one of these templates, localizing it to your local school, creating a virtual sample, and then just popping a simple little email over to your buyer. And these should be all over your Instagram and your Facebook. All your virtual samples should be all over the Instagram and Facebook. And it was interesting. My client, Tom from Stoga, it was pretty funny what he did. I sent him he emailed me. He said, hey, do you have the catalog? He knew we were doing Mask Builder. So he emailed me, said, hey, do you have the link to the catalog for Mask Builder? We haven't even launched our web page yet. And so I sent it to him, and he built it into his web page already. It was pretty funny. So it's like we hadn't even released the product, and he already had the catalog incorporated into his web page, which I thought was very clever and very smart of him to do that. Because what ends up happening is people maybe don't associate you with masks, right? They don't make the connection. They know that, you know, that they're out there, but they didn't know that you can do these really highly customized type masks and all these fundraising programs and things like that. So now you can get ideas in front of a customer. Now they associate you with that. So you might get your foot in the door with a mask, but that could lead to lots of other things. And I can guarantee you, you know, the consumption of masks in the schools, teams, and sports group is a very fast growing area, and it is competitive. Let's be candid about that. But if you have better graphics and things that look cooler, you're not going to get price shopped. You just aren't, because your graphics look way cooler than just the boring school logo. You know, you got a background, you got design elements, you got bright, vibrant colors. And that's honestly what Mask Builder is all about. And in hindsight, looking at what they did with these Packers masks, these are pretty boring compared to what we're doing with Graphics Builder. So maybe we even outdid some of these bigger companies here. So if you want to see more information on Graphics Builder and kind of what it's all about, if you go to the, or excuse me, Mask Builder, if you go to the Mask Builder page, there's a nice little overview video. You can purchase right directly from the website if that's something you want to do. If you're a Graphics Plus member, you guys are entitled, you guys have special pricing for Mask Builder as part of the Graphics Plus membership program. So you don't want to purchase it through this link. You want to contact us. If you're interested in becoming a Graphics Plus member, might be a good time to do it, because the savings that you'll get on with your membership will pay for your first month of a Graphics Plus Lite membership. So I mean, that's kind of a cool way to think about it. So there you go. That's the whole product. So what I want to do now, I'm going to stop the recorded portion of the webcast, and then we are going to open it up for questions.